Well, that brings us to the final piece here, and we're running pretty close on time for our session. We're going to work our way into the final piece, and this is the utilization piece. And I know, you know, we've talked a little bit about MindSphere and Internet of Things platform for Siemens and openness, and we have the good fortune to have Bill Boswell provide more details about that and how we're leveraging that and using that in our technology offerings and how it's helping to solve problems in our varied customer base. So Bill Boswell, thank you.
All right. Thank you, Jim. And it's always great to go last. And I'm going to take us through the utilization topic and talk about MindSphere. So we've heard a lot about how digitalization changes everything. And really what we're going to talk about next is how the Internet of Things and MindSphere changes everything. So when we talk about MindSphere, we talk about it as the cloud-based open IoT operating system. And today we're going to quickly go through four different topics: connectivity, open platform as a service, the powerful industry applications, and the connection back to the complete digital twin. So the first area we're going to talk about is how MindSphere changes everything by quickly and easily connecting real things to the digital world. And you've seen throughout the presentations and the demos today how important that connectivity is. So this is a diagram you'll see a lot of MindSphere. You saw it in Tony's presentation as well. If you start at the bottom of this, this is where we talk about connectivity. And it's about connecting products, products that were manufactured. It's about connecting plants, systems, machines, and all that can be done with MindConnect, which MindConnect is both hardware gateways as well as software libraries and software drivers that can be installed into other devices to allow devices to talk and connect directly to MindSphere. We do this through open standards like OPC UA. We also can talk the language of Siemens for controllers like the Cinemaric S7. MindSphere speaks S7 automatically, so any of the new controllers that come out from Siemens can talk the language of MindSphere directly. So that plug-and-play connection of both Siemens and third-party products through that OPC UA is very important to us. And of course, when you're talking about the Internet of Things, all of that has to be done in a very secure environment because you are connecting systems to the Internet. Now, the second thing we'll talk about is how MindSphere changes everything by creating a strong partner system, and we do that through this concept of open platform as a service. So at the platform as a service level, we move up from the bottom of this diagram into the middle and into the top, which you'll sometimes hear us talk about as northbound APIs. So they're the application programming interfaces that allow people to build powerful industry applications that run on top of MindSphere. And MindSphere itself supports all the major cloud infrastructures. And you can see some of them listed here from SAP and Atos. Microsoft Azure and Amazon Web Services is one of our newest ones. And all that, again, done through an open partner ecosystem that people can build applications that run on top of that environment. The third area we'll talk about is these powerful industry applications. And so that helps our customers and our partners to be able to drive business success with not only the applications, but we all know that the Internet of Things is going to change the way that people deliver business models around these digital services. So, getting back to the aviation theme here for a moment, we'll shift gears a little bit and think about this in the context of an airport. Here, this is a picture of a major European airport, and I'm sure many of you flew here to Indianapolis, and hopefully you didn't have any flight delays. I myself have had some overnighters in airports this summer, and that's not very fun. But the next worst thing to a canceled flight is what? Getting there without your baggage, right? So let's talk about some of the context for that. So one of the applications of MindSphere that's being used at a major European airport is 100% identification of potential failures in the baggage trail. So these are sensors that are on the motors, that are driving the belts, that are getting the luggage to the right place so it gets on your plane. And not only the baggage trail system itself, but the carts that maintain and move your luggage around the airport as well. So that's happening in MindSphere today. So this idea of condition-based maintenance, it maximizes uptime and the availability of systems. So if we take that concept one step further, one of the core applications that's delivered with MindSphere is fleet management.
And fleet management can be used to manage any kind of a fleet of equipment. So imagine now in the scenario we're going to talk about next, that you've seen how complex maintaining some of these systems are, that you need to have your worldwide operations staff that's doing the support of the aircraft in the field have the equipment that's always available, because if the technicians can't service the plane, can't verify that what's happening at the airport in the terminal, again, it can result in delayed flights. And so you want to make sure that the equipment that your field service technicians are using is always available. So one of the ways we can do that is by combining that power of big data and product intelligence with the IoT data. And Tony talked about that earlier today, and the way that we do that is with product intelligence for MindSphere. If you come to our sessions on Thursday, you'll also hear about a new version of product intelligence for Team Center that's powered by Omnio. And what this does is it allows us to make that connection back from the IoT data, combine that IoT data with data from other sources about the product as it's being manufactured, including out into the supply chain, and be able to identify issues, see trends, and do things that help you solve problems and prevent recalls and problems. So we're going to see a little snippet of that in action. This is an example of a Siemens Field PG. It's a hardened laptop that could be used in the service of those aircraft in the field, for example. What we do is we collect live IoT data from those laptops about the availabilities of those systems for the field technicians. And the MindSphere alerts are sent over to Omnio. Omnio can detect trends in that data, as is reported from MindSphere. In this case, we see that the solid-state devices, the disk drives in those systems are experiencing read-write problems. And now, because we've got that data from all of those other systems, we've detected that trend, and we can see if we're seeing that in any other systems before it really becomes a big problem in the field. Here, Omnio, through that discovery capability, has always running in the background. It's discovered 25 instances where there could be a correlated problem. And so we drill down into that now as the quality engineer, and we can see that the hard drives or the SSDs from the same supplier that are using revision A at factory 15 are really having the problem. So we're going to dive in to do a little root cause analysis of this. We jump into Team Center because Team Center and Omnio, or product intelligence for MindSphere, are connected, and we can go in and see where else this disk drive is used and what revisions of it are being used in the system. So here we can see that we're into the system, and we can use then the power of that to connect that back into the workflows with Team Center and drive the results back in the system. So I'm going to go a little quick today since we're out of time. The last area I'll finish up with is this idea that MindSphere changes everything by really enabling that closed loop innovation with a complete digital twin. So we started out the day with Tony talking about the digital twin. You can see how you can take the performance data in the field, you can connect it back into the product twin, into the production twin, and be able to close that loop and connect back to the full digital enterprise software suite. So no other IoT provider can do that. People talk about the performance twin. That's great. We can do the performance twin as well, do the mathematical models. But when you see the power of tying that back into the simulation data, into the manufacturing processes, there are things that we can do that nobody else can do. So we're pretty excited about the IoT capabilities. And with that, I'm going to turn it back to Jim.
Okay, Bill, thank you very much. And I know it's been a little bit of a long session, but I hope you can appreciate the different topics that we've been able to touch base on. Historically, we would, you know, talk about one segment, the other segment, the other segment, and, you know, during the sessions this week, you can really dive deep into each of these topics, but we wanted to provide some examples of how this information flows horizontally and across these different important topics. And so whether we're talking about the digital product twin, which, as you all know, we have extensive experience in, and the production twin for some of our manufacturing solutions, and the new approaches here that we have in the digital performance twin and gathering in-service information, using that against the design product data is critical to helping you succeed with your new products in the future. With that, I would first like to thank the team, if they wouldn't mind coming back on stage just quickly here. A lot of hard work behind the delivery that we had today from our great team here. And I just wanted to express my appreciation for them. I would also like to recognize John Whetstone, who's here in the front. John helped keep this team together and pull it together. And our AV team, because this was, as you can imagine, quite a complex scenario for them to manage. So thank you all very much. And Alan, I would just invite you back up. Thanks, team.
Thanks,
To maybe add a few concluding comments.
Couple last thoughts. And first, thank you for highlighting our company and our aircraft in this. As I started with, I'm an airplane nut. I'm a pilot, but we are more than that. We're designers, engineers, managers. We manufacture things. And the reason I'm so excited about this is because of just a few words that were used. Integration with confidence. When you think about how we test things, we falsify, right? We test it till it breaks. And it's that iteration loop, the third word, that takes so much time, that costs so much money, and that in the end drives you away from product improvement, product differentiation that you need. So this, of course, is the future. This is why this is exciting. This is how do we do a better job? And of course, that's the whole point, is how do we do a better job? So thank you very much. It's really interesting stuff.
Thank you, Alan, very much for helping us with our presentation. Enjoy the rest of the week. Look forward to seeing everybody here throughout the sessions this week. Thank you very much.
Thank you.